Hello, this is Simone, and welcome to ARoadRetraveled. Let's go! Hello, this is Simone, and welcome to ARoadRetraveled. Today, we're taking a drive from Long Island to Manhattan. Long Island is about 45 minutes away from New York City, and you can either drive there or take the Long Island Railway, which we will take the next time we go. The only problem with driving into the city is finding parking. But today is Sunday, and parking, especially free parking, it's actually possible to find. But do not attempt this during work week. You'll run out of gas looking for parking and then break your bank account paying for a parking garage spot, which can easily be 20 bucks a pop. Today started out a little cloudy and it looks like it's beginning to rain. But I hope it'll clear up by the time we arrive in Manhattan. Let's go! Bridge is one of the most famous bridges in the world for many reasons. It's an icon of the New York City skyline, a national landmark, and one of the oldest suspension bridges in the United States that connects Brooklyn to Manhattan across the East River. Stretching nearly 6,000 feet, it was not only the largest suspension bridge in the world, but the first steel wire suspension bridge of its time. When construction began in 1870, steel was highly suspicious for durability and even illegal to use in any building structure in Great Britain. The architect, John Augustus Roebling, born in Germany, revolutionized bridge building but paid with his life due to a freak accident, and he died at the onset of the construction, so he never got to see the completion of his bridge. So his son, Washington Roebling, took over as chief engineer. But he didn't last long either. His health suffered dramatically from a sudden attack of crippling caisson disease, also known as the bends, a paralyzing and often deadly affliction that caused the death of three men and affected nearly all of the caisson laborers who worked in the underwater excavations for the foundations of the Brooklyn Bridge. During that time, you see, decompression chambers didn't exist, and there was little to be done to prevent the bends. The bridge cost $15.5 million to build and the lives of more than 27 people. In spite of deaths and debilitating accidents, a fire, corruption, and fraud, The bridge was completed in 14 years, with opening day on May 24, 1883, complete with a huge reception and fireworks. 150,000 people crossed the bridge on foot on the opening day, and at 5 p.m., it opened to vehicles. A total of 1,800 vehicles crossed on the first day. There was, though, a toll of 5 cents to drive across the bridge on its opening day. Pedestrians still shared a broken bridge with vehicles on a promenade, an addition defended by its original architect who predicted that it will serve well the people of New York. So here are a few more interesting facts about the Brooklyn Bridge. There are 4 suspension cables, each 15¾ inches wide and over 3,500 feet in length. Each cable has 5,434 wires, and the total of the wires are 14,060 miles. Wow! 144,000 vehicles cross the bridge on a daily basis on its 6 traffic lanes. Without the vehicles and pedestrians, the bridge weighs a whopping 14,680 tons. After the September 11 attack on the World Trade Center, the bridge was used by people in Manhattan to leave the city after subway service was suspended. The massive numbers of people on the bridge walking at the same time could not have been anticipated by John Roebling, but he designed it with 3 separate systems handling even unanticipated structural stresses. Roebling himself famously said, "If anything happens to one of his systems, the bridge may sag, but it will not fall." And he was right. The 3 bridges that span across the East River and connect Manhattan to Brooklyn are arranged from south to north: BMW, the Brooklyn Bridge, the Manhattan Bridge, and the Williamson Bridge. Okay, we'll get to see more of the Brooklyn Bridge today, so let's get going.